So any doubts to anyone?
No, sir.
So I'm starting with the lecture. So we have done the continuity equation, that was conservation of mass, and we saw that whichever route we follow, we essentially end up in similar kind of expression. And wait for a second. So we ended up in the last class with this. So that is, it does not matter what is your starting point, whether this or this, you end up in a quantity equation. That is the conservation of mass. All these equations, although they seem to be different from each other, they are actually one or other forms of each other. So now we have derived it for conservation of mass. The next step is we will be doing it the same thing for conservation of momentum, then conservation of energy. So as far as conservation of linear momentum is concerned, I'm writing down. Haan ji, bataiye. Any doubts? So I'm writing down here the Reynolds transport theorem again. This is for a non-deforming stationary control volume. So this is the governing Reynolds transport theorem. What is n here if you want to conserve momentum? What is capital N here? Sayyid?
Momentum.
Momentum. So I should write down M cap V. What is small n here? What is small n here? Siddharth.
Hello, sir.
Hi. What is small n?
Sir, I am audible.
You are audible. Hello. Siddharth. Siddharth, am I audible? Ujwal.
Yes, sir.
So yes, sir. What should small n equal to?
V. Yes, sir.
So what do you get? D by dt mv. This becomes equal to curly mv upon curly t for the control volume. And this becomes double integral n is v rho v dot da. Any doubts to anyone in this expression?
No, sir.
Now you already know you can simplify this further as you did for conservation of mass. So how can you simplify? You can put the values of surface integral as by Gauss divergence theorem, so that now you have equivalent volume integrals. So I am solving the right hand side first. So what is the right hand side? So curly by curly t. So mv, I can write down this as rho v dv. Any doubts to anyone? This is this term. Now by Gauss divergence theorem, what should I write down here? What should I write down here? Gauss divergence theorem. I want to convert this surface integral into a corresponding volume integral. What should I write down here? Saurabh.
Yes, sir.
What should I write down here?
Del dot V.
L dot?
Rho.
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 L dot rho V. Anything else?
To D.
Hanji?
Yes, sir.
DV.
Is anything else required here or not? Rishabh? Try to recall the Gauss divergence theorem and then answer this question. In this case, this is the vector.
आएगा
ही, वो तो इस तरह से हो गया ना, कुछ और आएगा यहाँ पे, एक और वी,
सर एक वी और आएगा ना सर, नीचे दो वी हैं,
क्लियर है?
यस सर.
बाय द वे, व्हाट इज दिस Have you ever heard about such operations? That V is a vector, there is another vector V. Neither it is dot, neither it is cross. So what is this? Have you ever seen that this kind of multiplication between two vectors?
No.
What do you think? What should be the case? So I am... For your benefit, so what do you say? Say if V was, say I write down here, say A was AI plus BJ, sorry, I should write down here, wait for a second. So I'm putting here A is equal to A1I plus A2J plus A3K. And so there's another vector called B vector, that is B1I plus B2J plus B3K. And if I multiply a vector by a scalar, say lambda, what should be this equal to? The lambda is the scalar.
All inwards multiply.
The lambda A1.
Lambda A1. Lambda
A2.
So it becomes lambda A1 I cap plus lambda A2 J cap plus lambda A3 K cap. Clear? Now what is A dot B equal to?
A1 B1 plus
A1 B1 A2 B2.
A2 B2.
A2B2 plus A3B3.
So please remember this kind of operation by this thing. I am writing down here. And this dot product is also called the inner product. Please remember from now onwards, dot product is also called inner product. And that means something like this. So I can write down this as A1, A2, A3 into B1, B2, B3. Is this matrix 1 by 3 or 3 by 1? 1/3. So what do you get? You get the same answer?
Yes, sir.
What you have done is actually every vector is always remember if I write down A, this could be written down as this thing. You should always remember. So vector is always a column matrix. That should be clear in mind. What I have done is I have taken a transpose of this. What does that
mean? Yes, sir.
This is actually A transpose into B. When I say A dot B, it means A transpose
B.
Clear? Now I'm coming to the other part, which is, I think, little bit new to you. That is, if I have A vector and I have a B vector and I don't put any dot here, neither I am putting any kind of cross here. So this kind of product is called outer product. Are you clear? And this essentially means A into B transpose. Now let me know, what should I do? What should be this equal to? What is A? A1, A2, A3. What is B transpose?
B1, B2, B3.
Row matrix. So what do you get? This is 3 into 1. This is 1 into 3. So what will you get as the answer?
Cross 3.
3 cross 3. So what should be the values? Can you help me writing down? What should be the values? I'm putting it here. What should I write down? What should I write down?
A1, B1. A1,
B1.
B1. A1, B2. A1, B2.
A1, B2 here.
Sir. A1, B3.
A1, B3. Okay. Then here.
A2, B1.
A2, B1.
A2, B2.
A2, B2.
A2, B3.
A2, B3. Then.
A3, B1.
A3, B2. And A3, B3.
B3.
Simplify this. This is just matrix multiplication. So this is what is meant by an outer product. So when I write down V and I side by write down another V, it essentially means this is resulting in this 3x3 matrix. That should be clear. Clear? Now you are clear with the dot product, with the outer product. So this is the outer product. Clear? Any doubts to anyone? So the right hand side becomes curly by curly T rho V plus del dot rho V V. And this everything is under this integral control volume into dV. Any doubts to anyone in the right hand side of the equation? This is the right hand side of the equation of the Reynolds transport theorem. Any doubts to anyone? So these two terms have been rewritten so that both could be combined under the same integral. Using Stokes theorem, using Gauss divergence theorem. So this is your right hand side. Any doubts to anyone? Now what about left hand side? What is this equal to? That is rate of change of momentum of the system. What is this equal to actually? If there is a system and its momentum is changing, what does that mean? This rate of change of momentum of the system should be equal to what?
Force applied.
Force applied. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So I'm writing down here dmv by dt is equal to force. And this is equal to the right hand side, what we have already done. This is curly rho v by curly t plus what was here, del dot rho v v. This is the outer product, everything. This is dv. Any doubts to anyone? So the left hand side could be written down as f. Now from your mechanics understanding, what do you think? Forces can be of how many types? I'm giving you a hint. I'm putting here as two arrows. So what should I write down here? What should I write down here? I've given you a hint that forces could be of two types in general. What can I write down here and here?
Forces, body forces and surface forces.
Yes, so you are correct. So this is surface forces and this is body forces. So these type of forces are clear to everyone? Is there any student, these concepts are not clear? Please ask me honestly, otherwise you will not be able to understand what are these. Kisi ko koi bhi doubt hai, please ask me without any kind of hesitation.
सर प्लीज रिपीट कर दीजिए, मेरा थोड़ा कनेक्शन लॉस्ट हो गया था.
अच्छा, तो कहां से आपको रिपीट कर दूं मैं?
ये दोनों फोर्सेस से सर, सरफेस एंड बॉडी फोर्सेस.
तो सरफेस फोर्सेस एंड बॉडी फोर्सेस, दीज आर फोर्सेस दैट कैन एक्ट ऑन एनी ऑब्जेक्ट. फॉर इंस्टेंस, से दिस वाज अ टेबल एंड से अ बुक वाज लाइंग हियर. से दिस वाज द बुक व्हिच वाज लाइंग ऑन द टेबल. So this is the table on which book is lying. So this is the book. Now if I want to understand what are the forces acting on this book, what will I do? I will draw a free body diagram of this book. Now let me know, what are the surface forces acting on this book? Surface means the force that is acting through a surface, that is, it requires some interface so that it can act on this book. So what is
normal
that?
Normal force and weight.
What is
reaction force?
Reaction force.
Reaction.
This reaction force is the surface force. Now, this surface force is acting only on this surface. It is not acting on any other surface. Neither it is acting on this surface, nor on this, nor on this. So please remember, surface forces are acting only on a given surface. They are not acting throughout. So this neta is acting only on this surface. Now, can you think about a force that is acting on each and every part of this book?
Gravitational body force.
Gravitational force. So gravitational force is a body force then. Although we show it like this, at the center of gravity, but actually that force is acting on each and every part of this book. That's why it is called body force. So this mg is the body force, this reaction is the surface force. So all the forces in engineering you can think about as either surface force or body force or combination of the two. Is that clear? Any doubts to anyone? Now, under surface forces, when the fluid is flowing, say this was a pipe, fluid is flowing, What do you think? What all surface forces can act on this? Any fluid? If this was
viscosity, a... viscosity and frictional force.
Hanji?
Viscosity, sir.
So one surface force would be viscous force. So this is one type of surface force. Any other?
Frictional force or boundary se no slip condition.
हाँ तो वो viscous में आ गई ना? Viscous force is due to viscosity only.
Pressure force.
Clear है? So we have identified two major forces, that is viscous force and pressure force. What about body force?
Gravitation, sir. Gravitation.
So gravitational force.
Or maybe agar electric field raha to electric field.
In certain cases there can be magnetic field or electric field, or there can be other body forces that like Coriolis force and all those forces. But we are not taking into account those forces, because those are not common in your engineering fluid mechanics. So that's why most of the body forces is predominantly gravitational only, as far as Earth fluid mechanics is concerned. If you are going to some planets, other planets where magnetic field is important, then we will have to take into account magnetic field also as a body force. And any doubts to anyone?
No, sir.
Now, if you include all kind of these body forces as well as surface forces, you actually end up in Cauchy equation and the Navier-Stokes equation. We will come to this. That is, if you have viscous forces as well as pressure forces, you take into account all these forces as well as the body force, that is gravitational force, then you end up in an equation called Cauchy equation or Navier-Stokes equation. But if you neglect viscous forces or neglect the effect of viscous forces, it is more appropriate to say the effect of viscous forces, because viscous forces will always be there. So neglect the viscous, if the effect of viscous forces, then you end up in Euler equation. Are you clear? So all these equations actually are defining what? Conservation of
linear momentum.
But they are known by different names depending on which terms we neglect and which terms we take. So it is as simple as that. So this is the most generic conservation of linear momentum equation. Now, which forces you account for, that results in a derived equation or a special case, and those special cases are known by different names. So please remember, in science, if you ask that if this was a general case, then why do we study these equations and why are these named after certain scientists? Why is not this named after certain scientists? So can you shed some light on this? Why this is not called the Navier-Stokes equation or the Cauchy equation or the Euler equation? Why these are called by different names? Anyone? Prashant?
No idea, sir.
So please always make a habit to at least try to attempt the answer. it may go wrong, but then you will develop a habit to answer questions. So I want you, I want some answer from you. I cannot take this answer, no idea. Prashant.
Yes, sir.
So at least give some answer, apply some brains, try to think and then give me answer.
Okay, sir.
I'm giving 30 seconds to each student. Then I want answers from your side.
So can you repeat the question?
My question is, this is the conservation of linear momentum, but this equation is not called by any special name. We are calling these equations in which there are certain assumptions by special names, that is Cauchy equation, Navier-Stokes equation, Euler equation. What is the reason? What do you think? What is the reason? Why can't we name the most general equation by a certain?
Because
it is a general equation and it is not
general. कहीं पे apply नहीं हो सकता.
It does not signify any force. Which type of force is acting on it? Surface force or body force? Viscous force?
Okay. So my follow-up question is: everyone has, I think, heard about this formula.
Yes, sir.
What
yes,
is this called?
Yes, sir. Newton of viscosity.
Newton's law of
viscosity.
Why there is name Newton here? And is this a universal formula?
Or Newtonian fluids ke liye to hai.
Only Newtonian fluids?
Yes, sir.
So please remember, as you study any subject, these generalizations were not originally there. So, कोई scientist किसी तरह के fluid पे कुछ काम कर रहा था, कोई scientist किसी और तरह के fluid पे काम कर रहा था, and they were actually building what? Only constitutive relationships. That is, they were doing some experiments on certain kind of fluids, and likewise. This Euler, Navier-Stokes, Cauchy, they were developing models for certain special kinds of fluids. They were not generalizing the theory. But now, because we know each and every character as such of the entire story, then we can say that actually these were nothing but special cases of the more general form of the equation. That is the beauty of science. In science, you don't come from a general case to special cases. It is the other way around. For instance, Prashant today discovered something or in some phenomena. Ujwal also discovered something. Sayyad discovered something. They might be discovering only some special case of some general phenomena. Then these phenomena will be called by their names, but actually they were part of this parent family. Is that clear?
For a particular yes, application.
So this is for a particular application. You are absolutely correct. So they were actually analyzing things depending on their interest for a particular application. But somehow it so happened that all of them were actually a special case of something general. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
That spirit should always be there in while studying any science subject. So mathematics is inherently different. It is the other way around. In mathematics, you define certain rules and then you can describe any kind of phenomena with using those rules. So that's an axiomatic subject. Whereas science subjects are not axiomatic. You always evolve in science subjects. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So these are the special cases of the more general format, that is conservation of linear momentum. Now I am deriving the simplest case, that is the case in which you don't account for viscous effects. That is, you don't account for viscous effects. That kind of conservation of linear momentum was provided by Euler, and that is called the Euler equation. So what does that tell you? I know that dmv by dt is equal to force. As far as Euler equation is concerned, what has happened is the surface force has gone to only which force?
Pressure force.
And body force only has
gravitational force.
So when this is the assumption, then I call this conservation of linear momentum as
Euler equation.
So this is equal to curly rho v by curly t plus del dot rho outer product VV, and this is any doubts to anyone. Now this is already there in a simplified format. So the derivation of Euler equation boils down to only quantifying these terms. So what do you think this pressure force can be written down as? So if this was a fluid flow, I take a differentially small element, because this is on the system, so I'm treating it from Lagrangian frame or Eulerian frame. And this left-hand side is Eulerian frame or Lagrangian frame?
Lagrangian.
And this right-hand side is
Eulerian.
Now this is connecting Lagrangian-Eulerian approach, and this was called the Reynolds transport theorem. In this special case, n happens to be momentum, nothing more than that. Now I want to find out the pressure force on a finite size control volume. So I choose, say, this finite size control volume. In this finite size control volume, which is moving with the flow, that is Lagrangian approach, in order to find out the force on this, I can find out force on a small element and then integrate it. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So now I am blowing this up. The small part here, so this is the small, differentially small control volume. Again, I have taken x, y, z. This is a, b, c, d, and this is, say, e, f, GH. Now what do you think? This is now not a finite size control volume fixed in space, but what is this? This is a finite size, differentially small control volume moving in space. So what are the forces acting on phase A, B, C, D? We have done away with viscous effects. So what will be the pressure force in this? In this direction, if pressure is, say, P,
P divided dz.
What will be pressure here? In opposite direction? What will be pressure here? P plus early P back early x into dx. This is dx, this is dy, this is dz. Clear? What about pressure force? Wait for a second, I think. What about pressure force on face this? So this is so A, B, C, D. So what about pressure force on C, G, H, D? This direction? If this is P, pressure force on A, B, F, E will be in the opposite direction. So this will be what? P plus curly P by?
Y.
Curly Y into?
D-I.
Likewise, I can take for the other direction as well. So this is some pressure force. This is P. So then pressure force here will be in opposite direction. This will be P plus curly P by curly Z into DZ.
Yes, sir.
What is the pressure force in X direction? In X direction. Pressure force in X direction. Minus?
A net.
Any doubts? Pressure force in X direction.
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
Likewise in Y and Z directions? In y direction, it will be minus curly P by curly Y, dx, dy, dz. And finally, in the z direction also, I have minus curly P by curly Z, dx, dy, dz. Any doubts to anyone? Any doubts to anyone? What do I get? Total force, I get like this. I'm writing down here, minus I take common, as well as I take dx, dy, dz as common. What I'm left with? Curly P by curly x, I cap, plus curly P by curly y, j cap, plus curly P by curly z, k cap. Any doubts to anyone? What is this term equal to? L, P? Any doubts to anyone? You clear it?
No, sir. Yes, sir.
So what I am finally left with? Minus del P into dx, dy, dz. So this was the surface force on this differentially small control volume. And this dx, dy, dz could be written down as dvp. What about body force? I have body force in which direction? I have body force only in y direction?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And that too in negative y direction. So if I have, now please be careful here, if body force vector B is represented by Bx plus By J plus Bzk, what should I write down? B is equal to actually By J only. And what is By equal to?
सर सर जेड डायरेक्शन के बाद का समझा दीजिए, कनेक्शन लॉस्ट हो गया था.
कौन सा जेड डायरेक्शन?
सर जो एक्स वाई एंड जेड ऊपर.
एक सेकंड, ये वाला?
यस सर.
तो ये समझ आ गया जेड डायरेक्शन?
यस सर, यहाँ तक समझ आ गया.
हाँ जी बताइए क्या कह रहे हैं.
यहाँ तक तो आ गया सर, इसके बाद का पता नहीं चला.
इसके बाद में क्या हुआ? जैसे ये इधर था फोर्स, ये इधर था फोर्स, तो नेट इधर फोर्स होगी एक्स डायरेक्शन में.
यस सर.
ऐसे वाई में, ऐसे जेड में.
यस सर.
अगर इनको मैं माइनस कर दूं, दिस माइनस दिस इनटू एरिया, तो मेरे पास बच जाएगा ये.
यस सर.
लाइकवाइज वाई में, लाइकवाइज
जेड
जेड. तो अब ये एक्स वाई जेड में है, तो एक कॉम्पोनेंट्स है फोर्सेस के.
यस सर.
अगर मुझे एक की वेक्टर फॉर्म में लिखना है इसको, मुझे आई जे के कैप से लिखना पड़ेगा इनको.
यस सर.
तो मैंने ये आई कैप इसके साथ कर दिया क्योंकि ये एक्स डायरेक्शन में है.
यस सर. यस सर.
वाई कैप इसके साथ, जे कैप इसके साथ, सॉरी के कैप इसके साथ.
यस सर.
एंड आई हैव रिटन डाउन दिस टर्म एज ग्रेडियंट ऑफ पी. यू ऑलरेडी नो दैट दिस कुड बी रिटन डाउन एज ग्रेडियंट ऑफ पी.
Yes, sir.
And this dx, dy, dz could be written as small differential, small volume dv.
So, it's a negative symbolized here, sir.
Anji?
Negative here.
Negative kyun aa raha hai?
It's symbolized kya kar raha hai, sir?
Symbolize ye kar raha hai. अब यहाँ पे हमारा ये है, जैसे अब आपको एग्जांपल बोलूं मैं, सिंबलाइज ये कर रहा है. जैसे आप, आपको याद होगा, आप ऐसे करते हो. अगर आपको याद हो, मान लो ये z डायरेक्शन है, तो आप क्या करते हो? dp by dz is equal to minus g. इसका मतलब क्या होता है? अगर यहां पे कोई z1 लोकेशन पे कोई पॉइंट है p, या कोई पॉइंट ऐसे a, इस पे प्रेशर क्या होगा? आप बोल देते हो रो जी z1.
Yes,
अगर ये Z2 है, तो यहाँ पे कितना होगा? ये B पॉइंट है, रो जी Z2. अरे क्लियर है? इसका मतलब क्या हुआ? अब मैं इसको अगर ऐसे इक्वेशन को देखूं, तो dp अपॉन dz इज इक्वल टू माइनस g. एंड व्हाट डज दैट स्टेट? दैट dp इज इक्वल टू dz इन into minus, this is minus g dz, and say z varies from 1 to 2, say I get minus g z2 minus z1 is equal to p2 minus p1. इसका मतलब हुआ p2 minus p1 is equal to g z1 minus g z2. अब इसका मीनिंग क्या है कि प्रेशर, अगर मैं z डायरेक्शन यहां से ले रहा हूं पॉजिटिव डायरेक्शन में, तो प्रेशर क्या हो रहा है?
डिक्रीज हो रहा है.
तो जब मैं dp by dz लिखता हूं, बेसिकली कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम मेरे पास ऐसे होता है. तो अगर मैं ऊपर जा रहा हूं, तो प्रेशर क्या हो रहा है? एक्चुअल में कम हो रहा है. So that's why I have a negative sign here. Nothing more than that.
Yes.
So this is negative sign here. And I know that this by is actually minus g, but I am putting it here. So by into j only. So what I'm left with is, I'm putting it here now, I get Fs, that is the body force, sorry, the surface force, as equal to what? Minus del P into dV. This was for differentially small control volume. I can do it like this. This becomes the total surface force. Are you clear? Any doubts to anyone in this expression? This was for differentially small control volume. I want it for the entire control volume, so I am simply integrating it across the entire control volume. to get the total surface force. Clear? Any doubts to anyone? Any doubts? Saurabh?
No, sir.
Excuse me, sir.
हाँ जी बताइए.
सर जो आपने बताया था कि जो बॉडी फोर्स होती है वो कंपोनेंट के हर एरिया पे मतलब कि हर पोर्शन पे इफेक्ट करती है.
हाँ.
तो फिर यहाँ पे आपने इस एलिमेंट के सिर्फ वाई डायरेक्शन में क्यों बॉडी फोर्स को लिया और डायरेक्शन में क्यों लिया?
हर देखो बॉडी फोर्स का मतलब होता है जो जैसे अगर ये कोई भी आर्बिट्री बॉडी है मान लो ये इसको मैंने इस सपोर्ट पे रखा होता.
हाँ जी.
तो सरफेस फोर्स तो सिर्फ इतने पोर्शन पे लगेगी ये वाले पोर्शन पे इस पे ठीक है. लेकिन बॉडी फोर्स कहाँ कहाँ लग रही है? यहां भी लग रही है, यहां हर जगह लग रही है. अब वो बॉडी फोर्स किस डायरेक्शन में लग रही है वो भी तो वेरी कर सकता है.
ओके.
जब मैं बोलता हूं ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स तो इसका मतलब क्या हुआ? हर पॉइंट पे क्या लग रहा होगा फोर्स किस डायरेक्शन में?
डाउनवर्ड.
डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन. मान लो आप यहां पे अर्थ पे थे, आप यहां पे खड़े थे तो आपको ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स इस डायरेक्शन में लगती है. ठीक है.
Yes.
मान लो यहां पे एक और बहुत बड़ा प्लेनेट होता तो आपको ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स इस प्लेनेट की वजह से भी लगती?
Yes, sir.
तो बॉडी फोर्स का कंपोनेंट क्या हो जाते हैं? एक ये डायरेक्शन भी होती है और एक ये भी होती. तो बॉडी फोर्स अकेली वाई डायरेक्शन में तो ना होती. उसका कुछ एक्स कंपोनेंट भी होता, शायद कुछ जेड कंपोनेंट भी होता.
यस सर.
आप समझ रहे हैं?
क्योंकि
हम सिर्फ ग्रेविटेशनल बॉडी फोर्स को एक्सपीरियंस करते हैं. ऑल्दो जैसे टाइड्स वगैरह हैं, टाइड्स तो आपको पता है मून की ग्रेविटेशन की वजह से.
यस सर.
तो मून तो बहुत ही स्मॉल साइज है. अगर यहां पे बहुत बड़ा प्लैनेट हमारे क्लोज होता we would have experienced a pull, gravitational pull, and then the body force could not be simply stated as in negative y direction. Then it would have some components in x, y as well as z, and all our processes would have been entirely different. तो आपको trees जो दिख रहे हैं, जो human का body का structure है, everything would have changed. So actually all living beings have evolved under this gravitational force. So all the processes that nature engineers, it also takes into account the gravitational force.